हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट रेगुलेशन ऑफ ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल और ब्लड ग्लूकोज होम्योस्टेसिस। होम्योस्टेसिस इज अ टर्म विच इज़ यूज फॉर मेटाबॉलिक इक्विलिब्रियम। इन आवर बॉडी द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल इज मेंटेन्ड बाय द एक्शन ऑफ टू जनरल अपोजिंग फैक्टर्स। वन, द रेट ऑफ ग्लूकोज एंट्रेंस टू द ब्लड, एंड सेकेंड, रेट ऑफ रिमूवल ऑफ ब्लड ग्लूकोज। If there is disturbance between these two factors, that is entrance of glucose to blood and removal of blood from and removal of blood glucose, then there is disturbance in the homeostasis system of our body, and then give rise to a problem that is known as a disease, that is diabetes. There are basically two main types of diabetes: type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes. Type 1 diabetes is also known as juvenile onset or insulin dependent diabetes, which starts at very early age, and type 2 diabetes is also known as non-insulin dependent diabetes. In type 1 diabetes, the immune system suddenly attacks and irreversibly destroys the insulin producing cells of the pancreas, means the pancreatic cells, they can't further produce insulin. In this type of disease, the people cannot produce insulin, hence they should get insulin through insulin injections. Whereas in type 2 diabetes, the cells becomes resistant to the effect of insulin over a long period of time, so the patient has to take medicines. There are two main hormones which are responsible for maintaining blood glucose level, and these are insulin and glucagon. Insulin, which is secreted by beta cells of pancreas, and glucagon, which is secreted by alpha cells of pancreas. And these two hormones maintains blood glucose level. Both these hormones are secreted by islet cells within the pancreas and thus are referred to as pancreatic endocrine hormones. They are both secreted in response to blood sugar levels, diabetes, that is high sugar level in blood, hypoglycemia, that is low sugar level in blood, or some other sugar problems, but in opposite fashion. Now we will discuss role of insulin and glucagon one by one. First, role of insulin in control of blood glucose level. Insulin is normally secreted by beta cells of the pancreas. So for the secretion of insulin by the beta cell is a high, this is basically a stimulus, which is that is high blood glucose level. Although there is always a low level of insulin secreted by pancreas, the amount secreted into the blood increases as the blood glucose rises. Similarly, as blood glucose falls, the amount of insulin secreted by the pancreatic islets goes down. So we can see this with the help of this figure, which shows the intimate relationship between insulin and glucagon. First, I'll discuss the role of insulin or how it is secreted. So for the secretion of insulin by the pancreas, the triggering factor is high blood glucose. If there is a high blood glucose, then what happens? It trigger pancreas to secrete insulin by beta cells of the pancreas. So as the insulin secreted out, then what does it do? It gives instructions to fat cells to take up extra glucose from blood, as a result of which plays an important role in achieving normal blood glucose levels. So this is the role of insulin, how it maintains a blood glucose level to the normal level. Insulin has an effect on a number of cells, including muscles, red blood cells, and fat cells. In response to insulin, these cells absorb glucose out of blood, having the net effect of lowering the high blood glucose levels into the normal range. Now, I'll discuss the role of glucagon in blood glucose control. Glucagon is secreted by the alpha cell of by alpha cells of the pancreatic islet in much the same manner as insulin, except in the opposite direction, because these two are working in the opposite direction. When there is a high blood glucose level, then insulin comes in picture, and when there is low blood glucose level, then glucagon comes in picture. When blood glucose level goes low, however, more and more glucagon is secreted. Like insulin, glucagon has an effect on many cells of the body, but most notably the liver. The effect of glucagon is to make the liver release the glucose it has stored in its cells into the bloodstream, with the net effect of increasing blood glucose. So this thing we can see here. When there is a low blood glucose, then what does it do? It triggers pancreas for the secretion of glucagon by alpha cells. Then it gives instructions to liver to release glucose into blood to achieve a normal blood glucose level. Then the level becomes normal in both the cases. If there is a high blood glucose, then insulin comes in picture. When there is low blood glucose, then glucagon comes into picture. Glucagon also induces the liver to make glucose out of building blocks obtained from other nutrients found in the body, like protein. Apart from these two hormones, adrenal glands, pituitary glands, and thyroid glands also release hormones that regulates blood glucose level in bloodstream. Our body desires blood glucose to be maintained between normal range. So the normal range of blood glucose is between 70 mg per deciliter to 110 mg per deciliter in case of fasting. Less than 70 mg per deciliter is known as hypoglycemia, and normal range of blood glucose ranges between 120 to 180 mg per deciliter in case of PP. PP means the sample that is taken after 2 to 3 hours of having meal. More than 20 mg per deciliter is termed hyperglycemia. And how this is detected or how this is diagnosed? After drinking a sugar water drink, which is also known as a glucose tolerance test 2 or 3 times, and which reflects to, if it reflects too much glucose in the blood, then a patient is diagnosed with diabetes. Thank you.